Hello, as I said in the last class, today we are going to see, to discuss the structure of the Brazilian judicial system, okay? We will see the Supreme Federal Court, the Superior Court, and other courts of the system, okay? I will put on the board the structure of the Brazilian judiciary system right now. So we have here the Supreme Federal Court, that is the most important court of the country. Okay, the court that decides cases such as unconstitutionality of laws and so on. Well, let's go. Okay, so we have here the structure of the Superior Courts and the Supreme Federal Court here in Brazil. I didn't put here yet the structure of the other courts, like the Regional Labor Court, Federal Regional Court, Electoral Regional Court, and military justice. Okay, let's talk for now. At this moment, we will just talk about this structure. Well, as I said before, the Brazilian judicial system comprises the Supreme Federal Court, here, the Superior Courts, all here, 1, 2, 3, and 4, the Federal Regional Court, the State Courts, federal and state judges. The Supreme Federal Court and the Superior Court, which are the Superior Court of Justice, the Superior Labor Court, the Superior Electoral Court, and the Superior Military Court, all these courts have seat in the federal capital, Brasilia, and have jurisdiction over the entire Brazilian territory, The National Council of Justice also has a seat in the federal capital, but it has no jurisdiction, no jurisdiction at all. Just that's the way that I did in this way to defer for this one, okay? The National Council of Justice, even though it's a very important institution, it does not have jurisdiction. What does it do? It just oversees the judiciary administrative activity. Supreme Federal Court. Let's talk about the Supreme Federal Court. First, is the most important court of the country. The most important. There is no other court above it, It deals with constitutional issues. The Supreme Federal Court has a broad list of original jurisdiction, very large. I will select the following. I will select the following original jurisdiction. According to the federal constitution, the Supreme Federal Court has original jurisdiction to institute judicial proceedings and trials of criminal offense committed by the President and the Vice President of the Republic. The ministers of the executive body, senators and the representatives, and also conflicts of powers among the superior courts or disputes and conflicts between the union and the states and the union and the federal district. That is the original jurisdiction of the Supreme Federal Court. Also, the Supreme Federal Court has original jurisdiction to judge direct action of unconstitutionality. Direct action of unconstitutionality that I commented, I'm almost sure, in a previous class. Okay, class number 2 or 3, I'm not sure about, but I have commented that. Direct action of unconstitutionality of federal law or state law or normative act, and declaratory action of constitutionality of a federal law or normative act. Okay, so that is the original jurisdiction. Appellate jurisdiction over all constitutional issues, since the appellant demonstrates that his or her appeal transcends his or her own interest. I mean, go beyond his or her private interest. So, if someone needs to file an appeal from this court to the Supreme Federal Court, she must demonstrate that the appeal that he or her is dealing with is beyond over their own interest. Okay? Well, the Supreme Federal Court is composed by 11 justices. 11. Okay? 11 justices. In the United States, the Supreme Court has 9 justices. In Brazil, we have in the Supreme Federal Court 11, according to the federal constitution. The 11 justices are chosen among Brazilian citizens over 35 and under 65 years of age, of notable juridical learning and spotless reputation. As in the USA, it is the private prerogative of the President of the Republic to appoint the justice to the Senate, which the Senate may approve or not by an absolute majority. I mean, how the system works here in Brazil. The President of the Republic selects a name of a jurist, then it appoints the name to the Senate, and the Senate will hear the name that he appointed, okay, and then decide if approve or not the name to the Supreme Federal Court, the same way that happens in the North American system. In fact, we got the inspiration in the Constitution of the United States of America of 1787. Okay? Well, let's go. Let's continue. National Council of Justice. So I talked about the Supreme Federal Court, the composition, the original jurisdiction, the appellate jurisdiction. Let's see now the National Council of Justice. It's a very fascinating institution. The National Council of Justice is a relative new institution in our system. It was created by the Constitution Amendment number 45 from December 8, 2004. The National Council of Justice is composed by 15 members. 15. The Supreme Federal Court, 11. The National Council of Justice, just 15 members, appointed for a 2-year term of office, one reappointment being permitted, and it has seat in the federal capital. So they have a term, yeah? They have a term. And then one reappointment is permitted, and they have seat in the federal capital as the Supreme as the members of the Supreme Federal Court, as the Superior Labor Court, and the other Superior Court. All the members of the Council shall be appointed by the President of the Republic after their nomination has been approved by the absolute majority of the Federal Senate. After the Constitution Amendment number 61 of 2009, this rule does not apply to the Chief Justice, that now, according to the Federal Constitution, is the natural President of the Council, the Chief Justice. Here in Brazil, we don't call Chief Justice. We call President of the Supreme Federal Court. But let's say the Chief Justice of the Supreme Federal Court is also the President of the National Council of Justice. Okay? He's the natural president of the Council. And thus, his her name does not need to undergo the Senate approval. Okay? So who will need the Senate approval to go to the National Council of Justice? Just 14 members. Because, let's repeat, the President, the Chief Justice, does not need to undergo to the approval of the Federal Senate. The 15 members of the National Council of Justice are selected from different institutions, all of them linked directly or indirectly with the judicial system. The Chief Justice of the Supreme Federal Court is the President of the National Council of Justice, as I said before. The Superior Court of Justice, and the Superior Labor Court shall nominate one justice each. Okay? Superior Court of Justice nominate one justice, and the Superior Labor Court one justice. So, 1, 2, plus the Chief Justice, 3, among the 15. Okay? A judge of the State Court of Justice, that I didn't put the State Court of Justice here yet, there are 27 in the country, we have 27 states in the country, okay? So the State Court of Justice, the appellate court, they shall nominate a state judge, okay? They indicate in the Supreme Federal Court nominate. A judge of a federal regional court, there are 5 federal regional courts in the country, and the federal judge shall be nominated by the Superior Court of Justice. Okay, the federal regional court indicate one, and the Superior Court of Justice nominate the name to the Senate. And a judge of a labor regional court, and the labor judge shall be nominated by the Superior Labor Court. In order to complete the 15 members, there are six more members. Two from the public prosecution office, one state and one federal, two. One state from the public prosecution office and one for the federal public prosecution office, okay? Nominated by the Attorney General of the Republic. Two lawyers nominated by the Federal Board of the Brazilian Bar Association. And two citizens of notable juridical learning and spotless reputation, one of whom nominated by the Chamber of the Deputies, that is the House of Representatives, equivalent the House of Representatives, and the other one by the Federal Senate. Okay, background discussion about the creation of the National Council of Justice. There was a huge discussion before the creation of the NCO. Okay? What was the discussion about? The discussion about concerning constitutional issues as the judiciary's independence. The judges did not want the National Council of Justice. Why they did not want? Because they thought, and maybe they still think, that the National Council could interfere in their judgments. Okay? Because the National Council of Justice oversees the administrative works of the judiciary system. Different judges' associations joined force in order to stop the discussion of the constitutional amendment in the National Congress, but they did not succeed in their attempt to avoid the approval. Okay, they did not succeed. At the time, the Brazilian society shared a feeling that even though the judge's constitutional guarantees must be preserved, and also thought and still think that something had to be done in order to supervise the judge performance. I mean, at that time, the Brazilian society felt in that way, maybe they still feel that the judge's work must have a kind of supervise to see if their performance was good or not. The NCO is a very effective tool, a very effective institution. Soon, the National Council of Justice revealed itself as a very useful tool in order to accomplish its constitutional goals, which are many, such as to control the administrative and financial operation of the judicial branch and the proper discharge of official duties by judges. It also has the competence to receive and examine complaints against members or bodies of the judicial branch. The National Council cannot review any judicial decision because, as I said in the beginning, the National Council of Justice does not have jurisdiction, so it cannot review any judicial decision, but it can supervise the time that courts and judges take to deliver their decision and how their own court analyzes and decides acts of misconduct and accusations against judges and justice. In this particular field, the National Council has done a very good job, effective job, especially when the Justice Eliana Calmon was the Corregedor Justice during two-year term, 2010-2012. When she did a very effective job which got national attention in the demuration. Eliana Calmon is a woman, is a Superior Court justice, and also the first woman to have a seat in a Superior Court back in the 90s. She was very brave in fighting against conservative groups within the judiciary in all levels, and was lucky in having the national media at her side in fighting against corruption inside the system, especially because she used strong words to describe what she found out in the judiciary system. She used words like thief in robe. As everybody knows, robe is the traditional judge's coats. For the press, it was terrific. A woman, justice, in a very important position, because she was the corregidor, she belongs to the Superior Court of Justice, and she was the corregidor of the National Council of Justice, in a very important position, using strong words to denounce corruption in some part of the judiciary, with a huge popular support. She had a huge popular support. And more, with the entire majority of the judges, the Chief Justice included, the majority of judges and the Chief Justice included, took a stand against her, against Eliana Calmon. This fight was a gift handed to the journalists, and they made a big case about this issue, about the Eliana Calmon's fights against the corruption inside the judiciary system. Old problems that seemed impossible to deal with. The indubitable fact is that the judiciary, as any other government branch, has problems, and the National Council of Justice has identified ways of trying to fix most of them, especially in the state courts, where the statistics show the problem was bigger, such as poor record on punishment for judges' misconduct. It means that accusation against judges, especially in the states where we have 27 states here in Brazil, as I said before, were not investigated or not as it was expected for a democracy. In some states, almost no age limit for some court judges who received salaries above the constitutional boundaries. Many cases of a large number of judges' relatives holding position within the courts. That's what we call here in Brazil nepotismo, a word with a Latin orange, that describes authorities who keep their relatives in government positions paid by the public budget. Before the National Council started its job, there was a consensus in our society that even though the Brazilian democracy became strong due to the 1988 Federal Constitution, the present Constitution, with a reasonable system of check and balance, the judiciary as a whole needed to change some of its practice, and more than that, needed to be supervised in some way. The crucial point was how to implement that without threatening the judiciary's independence, absolutely indispensable to the functioning of any democracy. The response for that was the implementation of the Constitutional Amendment 45, adopted in 2004, which created the National Council of Justice, capable to supervise just some judiciary issues, not going into the judge's independence to decide a constitutional value that must be preserved. I mean, the society knew that something need to be done about the problems inside the judiciary system. And one of the tools, one of the possibilities was to create the National Council of Justice. But at the same time, there was a kind of controversy, a kind of constitutional doubt, because how to fix the problem without threatening the judge's independence. That was the case. A well-known Brazilian writer once said that all unanimity is dumb. His name is Nelson Rodrigues. Among journalists, lawyers, and common people, the National Council of Justice has been an unanimity. And we hope that it keeps this way, being a smart watchdog in defense of the good judges, who are the vast majority of the judiciary system in Brazil.